You're considering going to a coding boot camp and you're thinking about taking out loans and making that jump because you want to break into tech as a software developer. In this video, I'm going to tell you guys, as a coding boot camp graduate, what I think the pros and cons are of going to coding boot camp and teaching yourself to code in 2021. If you guys want to know more, stick around to the end of the video. My name is Darian. This is Darian the Dev. And if you're brand new to the channel, we talk about everything from tech, entrepreneurship, coding, startups, all that good stuff here on this channel. So if you guys are into that, make sure you like, share, and subscribe, because that's all we get into here on this channel. I'm only going to highlight the key points because I've already had other videos on the channel where I kind of go through the pros and cons of these two things. But in this one, I'm going to just focus on the main differences and just pretty much weighing them against one another. And then that way you guys can at least have a bootcamp graduate's perspective of the two, if that makes sense. So, all right, here we go. Okay, so a coding bootcamp is going to be expensive, all right? Like, that's just off rip. Any sort of coding bootcamp or program is gonna be expensive compared to you teaching yourself or doing any sort of self-study. Now, I won't say that this one is gonna be expensive and this one's gonna be cheap, because you could still spend a lot of money or thousands of dollars trying to buy, you know, educational courses or enrolling in things that are gonna teach you how to code on your own and buying tools and things like that. But at the same time, you're gonna spend a lot less, more than likely over here, buying your own set of tools and courses and programs than you are for just one program with a coding bootcamp or one of these apprenticeships. Now, another thing that I think is gonna be like equalizer in your decision is the fact that they're both going to be virtual now. Now, when I went to coding bootcamp in 2018, my bootcamp was actually in person. So I got to sit with my teacher, my instructors, I got to be with my TAs and my classmates, and I got to ask questions and just have that overall classroom camaraderie or shared learning experience. I can't speak to that experience in the virtual realm, but I just know that there has to be some sort of loss of, you know, engagement or participation or enthusiasm or camaraderie with just being in the online slash like hybrid learning environment. Like I said, I haven't done it myself, so you guys feel free to let me know down in the comment section below if you guys are in a coding bootcamp virtually, or if you went through a virtual coding bootcamp. What was the engagement like with your teacher, your classmates, your TAs, and things like that? Was it engaging? Did you get one-on-one help? And was it the same as if you were basically learning in a classroom? So let me know that down in the comment section down below. But I think that is gonna be one of the most important things, because if you're gonna pay the same price to take a class virtually or a program virtually as you would have getting all those extra benefits of, like I said, having those extra office hours after, you know, the class ends to sit with your instructor, your TAs, or even working on problems after hours with your classmates and things like that at the co-working space. Now, I understand that you might still be able to do that online, but again, I just feel like it's hard to justify the same price of a physical coding bootcamp when you're working hybrid or virtually and you're not commuting to the place and like paying for gas and paying for lunch. It just doesn't make as much sense to pay the same exact price to be in a virtual kind of learning setting. Now, the same thing is gonna be said for self-learning, except you guys don't have to pay extra to be at your own house and buy your own courses and learn at your own pace. And speaking of learning at your own pace, that's another thing that is different when you're doing self-taught versus in a coding bootcamp. In a coding bootcamp, guys, you're gonna have to be aligned with that 12-week curriculum, 14-week curriculum, 32-week curriculum, whatever it is, no matter how many weeks it is, they're gonna expect you to be up to speed with wherever your classmates are, no matter what the, you know, virtual hybrid learning setting is like, no matter what the instruction quality is like, they're gonna still expect you to be where everyone else is at the same time in the program. Because once you all graduate, they're gonna feel like they gave you the knowledge and the skills and the experience that you needed to basically get a job, and they're not likely gonna help you very much once you graduate the coding bootcamp. So if you spend all that money, but you're not able to keep up with the curriculum or where they expect you to be, then you'd be spending a lot of money to just fall behind and be confused and not get what you're really paying for, versus being able to do that at your own pace with the self-taught curriculum. So another thing to just keep in mind there is the pace of the curriculum and how you are as a learner. That's gonna be very, very specific to you as a person and how you learn. So the next thing that I think is important to consider between these two learning formats is going to be the collaboration experience. So you're gonna have an opportunity to work with other people when you're in a coding bootcamp. You're gonna build a project with them, a midterm, or something. You're gonna use version control and you're gonna be pushing code with other people to build projects. And that's gonna be super, super important when you go on the interview hunt to actually be able to describe a process where you had to work with a team to build a project as a developer. So I'm not saying that you cannot get that in the self-taught format, but what I'm saying is that you're gonna have to do more work to find those people to work with. So in a coding bootcamp, you'll have a bunch of people who are in coding bootcamp with you, or you'll be even put on a team of people that you have to work with who are gonna also be trying to learn Git and how to do version control and working on the same project, the same curriculum, learning the same languages as you and things like that. Versus when you're self-taught and you're trying to find people to collaborate with, you're gonna need to find people that are into coding, who know the same languages as you, or that are in a similar experience level as you, or maybe not, but just somebody who's willing to work with you and willing to, you know, help you build something or make commits with you on a project. Because otherwise you won't really have that experience when you go on the job interview front. And no matter how many apps you build or how much stuff you do, it's going to be expected by the time you start interviewing for jobs that at some point you've built things with other people. So that's just one thing to consider that could be kind of more work if you're going the self-taught route, is that you'll have to go find and build your own network of people to collaborate with. Now, there's always open source projects that you could join or be a part of, but just again, keep in mind that that's something that you will have to do on your own to really get that same experience. The next thing I'll say is that when you're in a coding bootcamp, you're exposed to a very limited number of topics about tech and about coding specifically, because it's all based around a 12, 14, or 32 week format. And there's a curriculum that the instructors have to follow. So there's topics that need to get covered, and there's a certain priority to them, and there's a certain order they need to cover them in. And that also means that there's a lot they cannot teach you in that 12, 14, or 32 weeks, because there's just so much to learn. So with that being said, even though you're learning a lot of things at a coding bootcamp and you're getting a like crash course in computer science, at the same time, there's still, for that price that you're gonna pay, there's so much that you're not going to be exposed to, not because they're scamming you or ripping you off. It's just that there's just no way you're going to really master or grasp all the concepts that you're learning within that time frame of the bootcamp. But then on top of that, there's just so many things that are just beyond your level of experience at that point. And tech is just such a far-reaching industry that there's just so many avenues of things as a developer you can get into, specialties that they just don't have time to teach you in the bootcamp. So regardless, there will be a self-study phase after you graduate the coding bootcamp that will continue likely for the rest of your career as a developer. But at the same time, if you initially go the self-study route, there will be a lot more opportunities for you to be exposed to more topics straight away, because you just have the power of the internet, and whatever you are interested in or whatever you want to research or whatever you want to dive into, you can do that, you know, at your own pace without costing as much as a self-taught developer. So whether that's DevOps, security, database stuff, cloud architecture, whatever it is, you can spend as much time on that as you want learning those topics when you're doing self-taught, whereas you might not learn some of those at all or just very little in a coding bootcamp. Another thing, I don't even know what number we're on at this point, guys, but another thing to keep in mind with coding bootcamps, you're going to actually get some Scrum or some Agile experience, which is going to be important for getting your first job or going through that interview process as well, because this goes back to working with other people. But on top of working with other developers, it's going to be expected that you've worked with other developers in an agile way or in a, you know, Scrum format. So that means having a daily stand-up meeting and understanding the roles of Scrum Masters and project managers and sprints and things like that. That's going to be expected by the time you start going on job interviews, unless you're interviewing for maybe like a junior developer position. But even then, that sort of experience is going to be preferred over somebody who doesn't have that experience. So again, if you're going to go the self-taught route, you're not going to get any sort of Scrum or Agile project management experience, but you're also not going to get any sort of collaboration experience unless you guys go out and get active on communities like this on the Darian the Dev channel, or you guys go to Stack Overflow or AngelList or wherever you guys want to go to network and talk to other developers or people who are aspiring developers and, you know, figure out what they're working on, how you can contribute, or how you guys can come together to kind of bring your learning experience, you know, full circle and give each other that Scrum and Agile experience, and as well as that project and collaboration experience with each other, because that's going to be really important when you're going on your job hunt. Another thing is going to be that when you're a self-taught developer, there's not going to be a ton of one-on-one support. There's no one there to really walk you through why your solution is wrong. You're gonna spend a lot of time doing a lot of research, doing a lot of Googling, a lot of Stack Overflowing, a lot of reading other people's code. But I really feel like that's kind of the better way to learn, because through all that pain and struggling of reading all those articles and going through all those hitting your head moments, that's when the concepts really get like forced into your mind and you like never forget them because you had that experience where you had to go through that. Whereas with a coding bootcamp, you're likely going to get more one-on-one support, whether that's on the weekend or after hours, whatever the bootcamp offers, you'll get more help with a teacher and they can help kind of save you some of those roadblocks and those headaches, and they can kind of tell you where you're going wrong or how you're thinking about something wrong, which is really useful. I just don't know if it's like $10,000+ useful. So you'll have more one-on-one support in a coding bootcamp than you will as a self-taught learner, but I think that could either be a pro or a con, really just depending on the person. And the last thing that I'll say, guys, that is a key difference between the two is that you may or may not have career counselors in your coding bootcamp who are there to actually help you update your resume, update your LinkedIn, make yourself more attractive as a candidate for a junior developer position. Maybe even open their network of employers to help get you interviews and things like that if they're really good. But at the same time, if you go the self-taught route, you likely won't get that same like one-on-one interpersonal career counseling or that career help. But at the same time, there's no guarantee that it'll really turn into anything in terms of a job offer either. So you could pay a lot of money for that service at a coding bootcamp and still not even get a job after the coding bootcamp, or you could kind of do your own research and use your own network and other people, you know, in other resources online to be your own career counselor in a way and update your own LinkedIn and update your own resume and kind of figure out the best way to do a job search or a job hunt for IT and tech and junior developer roles on your own. And then again, just saving that money and time and all that it kind of comes with expecting the bootcamp to do all those things. So in this one, guys, I really just wanted to give you guys a realistic approach to what you can expect if you go the self-taught developer route or you go the coding bootcamp graduate route. And like I said, I went to coding bootcamp in 2018. I'm not shy about it. It changed my life. And I have videos on this channel where I go more in depth about that experience too, if you guys want to check it out. But I still want to be honest with my viewers and my subscribers and let you guys know what it really is, in that you guys are paying for something that, you know, is not necessarily guaranteed, and it might not even be the most helpful thing for you. I really think you guys have to understand yourself before you make this big decision about going to coding bootcamp or to do the self-taught route, because so much of it is really dependent on who you are as a learner, how you learn, and who you are as a person. So I really hope that this helped you guys make a decision or clarify some things or whatever. But if not, please feel free, let me know down in the comment section below what you guys think, what questions I should answer, what questions you have. And also check out the description box down below for my free Intro to Coding Bootcamp course. It has everything in there I wish I knew before I went to coding bootcamp. It's completely free. Make sure you guys check it out. So this is Darian the Dev. Make sure you guys like, share, and subscribe. I really appreciate it. It helps me stay motivated to put this content out for you guys. And I will see you guys in the next video, all right? Peace.